Hi everyone, it's Sam from SiteMate. In this video, we're going to take a look at setting up project and team folders in Dashpivot. So what are project and team folders? Well, these are used to organize all of the information that you capture inside of Dashpivot. So all of your forms and all of your photos that you upload into the system. And in your account, you can create multiple project folders, and each project folder needs to contain at least one team folder, but there could be more team folders, as we'll see in just a moment. And each team folder has its own photos, templates, and analytics sections. So when you open up the Dashpivot website, if you want to see your projects and team folders, you just click on this button in the top left on the blue bar, and you'll see your company name and all of the project folders and team folders that sit within those projects listed in the sidebar. And this can be set up a couple of ways. For smaller companies looking for a simple sort of folder hierarchy, you'd be looking at setting up a general project with a single site team within it. And then all of your photos and all of your forms are going to go into that single site team. So it's the simplest way to set up Dashpivot. As you get a bit bigger and you've got lots of project information, you're going to want to take a look at creating separate projects for each of the projects that you're running and creating a single site team within each of these. And this means that the photos and forms that are uploaded in this team relate to project A, and the photos and forms uploaded in this team relate to project B, and so on and so forth. And each time you have a new project, you just create a new project and add in a single site team. Now, an extension of this for larger companies is to have several teams within the project folder. So you can see here that this project A is broken up into four team folders where they're organized by different areas, and the same for project B. It could be organized by different areas, but it could also be broken down by work activities. So for example, civil works, tunneling works, M&E works, and so on. These teams should actually reflect crews in real life. So people who are working in zone one would have access to the team for zone one. People working in zone two would have access to the zone two team folder, and so on and so forth. The next variation is suited to companies that are working with many clients who have different sites or different projects. The idea here is to create a project for each client and then create a team folder for each of the sites or each of the projects. This is just a nice, neat way of organizing all of the relevant projects and sites for each client under a project folder. Here's another variation where you might have the region as the project folder, and then you could have your projects using those team folders. Again, it just helps to organize information hierarchically. And something that we often recommend for companies setting up processes where you don't want employees to see each other's forms is to create a project folder called employees and create a team folder for each person. And this way, processes like timesheets or leave requests, those templates can live in each of these team folders, but then only that person is added into that team folder. So Amy would have access to this team folder, Ben would have access to this team folder, Charlie to this folder, and so on. And it means that each person will only be able to see the forms that they've created within that folder. And so setting this up, it's best suited in cases where you've got processes or forms that you don't want to share between different people, so that you don't want Amy looking at Charlie's forms or Dina looking at Ben's forms and so on. So if you're new to Dashpivot and you've just signed up and created an account, when you open your sidebar, you'll probably see something like this, where you've got one project folder that says your first project, and that's going to contain one team folder that's called your first team. One of the first things that you're going to want to do when setting up your Dashpivot account is configure your folders appropriately by following one of the examples that we've covered in this video so far. It's really easy to add projects or teams by just clicking the green plus buttons here that say add project or add team. So let's do an example. We'll add a new project. Just going to call it Project A. and then we'll give it a team name. So if we're a small organization, we might call this just site team. But if we're working on a large project that has lots of people working on it, we may end up going down the route of creating multiple teams. In this case, let's create three teams, zone one, zone two, and zone three, and click save. So now when we open the sidebar, we see that we've got the one project folder with three team folders within that for the different zones. It's really easy to edit the names of these teams or delete them by clicking either the pen icon to edit the name or clicking the red trash icon to delete the team. And the same applies for projects. So we get the same icons. It's worth noting that only organization controllers can set up project folders and team folders. So if you're the first person who's created your company's Dashpivot account, by default, you'll be set up as an organization controller. So you should see these buttons when you open up the sidebar. But for other people that you then later add in as team members or team controllers, they won't be able to add, edit, or delete any of the project folders or team folders. The project controller permission will be able to add and remove and edit the teams, but only within the project where they're set up as a project controller. And that's it. That's how you can set up project and team folders inside of Dashpivot. Once you've set them up, you'll want to go ahead and start adding in the relevant templates into each team folder and inviting the right people into each team folder so that they can start populating information in there, filling out your forms and uploading your photos. It is worth noting that the photos and forms created are stored within the team folders rather than within the project folder. So you'll notice that in the mobile app, you can't actually click on the project folder. You have to click on a team folder because this is where all of your photos and forms are actually created. So if you get stuck with anything, we do have some other videos and articles outlining other aspects of Dashpivot, covering off, you know, the photos, analytics, and template sections. Just click on the tutorials link up the top. But if you get stuck, you can always flick a message through to our support team just via the live chat button down the bottom here. So I hope that this video has been useful, and thanks for watching.